I think all of you know I'm pretty good at, when I get the mic, I'm gonna go ahead and talk. So, you know, first of all, you know, today's a little bittersweet. You know, this has been my home for the last 14 years. This is where I've raised my children. So this is not just about football, but it's about working for a great administration and working for your best friend as your athletic director and watching your children grow up in a community. And I said I wasn't going to get emotional today. But today's been hard. It's been tough. And everything that's transpired has been pretty quick. I've never thought about leaving Hoover. Like, that's, I'm not that kind of guy. I'm not a job searcher. I'm not sitting on the computer looking at Football Scoop to see what the next job is. It's just not me. I've always been where my feet are, and I want to make the most of every opportunity I have within the moment with the people that I'm around and make a difference. Today is looking back about the players that I've been able to coach and the appreciation I have for them, the coaches that have been on my staff, the administration in which, and the student body that in which I get to coach for, and the community in which I get to coach in. And, you know, football's changed a lot in the state of Alabama, especially in the last probably 15 years. And so, you know, for me, you know, it was time, it's an opportunity, and it was something I needed to pray about and look at. And me and my family felt like this was what we need to do for our family. And I get an opportunity to retire, but I'm not going to quit coaching by no means. I got plenty of more years left. But, you know, it's not going to be in state Alabama. And I wouldn't do that because I've had that opportunity the last few weeks with some people that have reached out. But there's never been a thought of me coaching anywhere in state Alabama. I'm in the best school. This is the best school. This is the best school system in the state of Alabama. And it's the best place to coach at. You got the best leadership, and there could be nothing better than that. So, you know, first of all, I want to say thank you to our administration. I want to say thank you to our coaches. Say thank you to all the players that I've been able to coach. I want to say thank you to the community. But I want to tell you this, and I want you to hear this. I want to say thank you to you. I'm not just doing that because we're standing here. There's some of you that are new faces, all right? But there's some guys that aren't here that were here in 2008. You know, Jeff's been around for a long time, you know. I'm not trying to tell you age, Jeff, but I mean, like, you have been around a long time. But the way you go about your business, and I hope that you felt like we handled you with respect and that we gave you every opportunity to get the story that you wanted. But I want to tell you how much I appreciate what you have done, not only for me, but for our players, our staff, our program, our school, and our community, and the exposure that you give us. And I appreciate you being out here today. I didn't want to make this about me. I know it's about me leaving here and everything else, but it's not about me. This is about everything that I've been able to do at Hoover High School because I've been surrounded by unbelievable people. And I've always just prided myself on doing it right. You know, it's about growing kids and impacting kids and hiring men of great character to impact our kids. And then, you know, it's about doing it right. It's about doing it by the rules. It's about making sure that we hold each other accountable. And at the end of the game, when it's all said and done, us being proud of what we've been able to accomplish, whether it was win, lose, or draw. And so, you know, to the Hoover Nation, you know, I just want to tell them how much I appreciate them and that I love them, and I'll always be a Hoover fan. And that's why I might be in another state, but that means that, hey, I can still wear that Hoover gear anytime I want to, and I'll always be a part of this community, and I hope they feel the same way. So I'll take any questions that you got. There'll be an announcement on Monday. Yep, there'll be an announcement on Monday, and then you know, there'll be some date, probably start effective somewhere for start of the new year. So.
Would it be high school, college?
It'll be high school. Yep. I'm a high school football coach, man. Look, there's been some college opportunities, and I've always thought about college, but you know what? That's just not in God's plan for me. And I've been coaching for 25 years, and my dad was a high school coach for over 30 years, and my brother's a high school football coach. It's on my staff now, and it's just what we've always been a part of. And to me, the game is so genuine and so pure, you know. And you know, I'm at a point right now in my career where I'm going to get another opportunity to coach in a community that loves football.
Gotcha. And I understand, you know, you've been here 14 years, so you've had that connection with students over the last 14 years. Kind of just tell us, you know, how hard was this breaking this to your athlete?
About as hard as it is standing here in front of you. I cried a lot this morning in front of my staff. My staff cried a lot. And let me just tell you this. This is how you know it's more than just football. I talked to our players this morning, and they were crying, and I was crying. But, you know, I've been places before. If you tell somebody, like, you're leaving, like, a lot of players are mad, and they just get up and they walk out because they don't understand it. Every single guy, when it was over with, we had a word of prayer together, and every one of them hugged me and told me they loved me, and they were crying. And that's how you know that it's more than just football at Hoover. And it's always been more than just football. Now, we've been a really good football team, right? And we got a really good football program. And I still think we were the best football team in 7A this past year. But I'm going to tell you, it's not about that. It's about what we do to try to grow our culture within those walls. And it was very emotional today to have to tell them. I mean, and I knew that was what it was going to be. So,
Josh, when you think of memories, what comes to mind first?
I don't know, standing here in front of this place. I can remember when my first opportunity to put on a Hoover pullover in 2008 and be like, man, is this for real, you know? And it was surreal. And I think some of my greatest memories were, there's different games that I think about, but it's also the voluntary Bible studies at my house on Wednesday nights. When guys are lost and don't know where they're at in life and you can help them find a way. It's those moments that I've had, like two nights ago, where I'm talking to one of our defensive linemen about college opportunities, and he reaches out to call me because he wants to know and he wants me to help him out, you know. So it's about those things. It's not just about football, but there are a lot of games that I love to think about and I'll always remember. But I think it's the times that I've spent with my staff, the times that we've spent in this community, and watching my kids grow up. No. And I think what I try to do is, and I'll do this where I go from here, is every year I just try to give a better version of myself. I don't try to reinvent myself. But I haven't been here 14 years. I've been here 1 year 14 times. And that's how I look at it. So every year's got to be a refocus, got to be renewed. And our guys will tell you, and you probably know if you've been around me long enough, you know every year we got an acronym. Every year we got some kind of word. Every year we got some kind of meaning. And I think that's where you have to be in life. So when you wake up every morning, you got to be 1% better. And I feel like as a program, we've continued to improve. Because look, getting to the top of the mountain is not the hardest part. It's staying up there. And staying up there by doing it the right way. And I pride myself on knowing that we've done ourselves the right way, and I'd be proud of that.
What kind of program do you think Hoover will be now that you're going to leave?
Look, let me just tell you this. I have a firm believer. I don't know if you've ever read the book Legacy by the All Blacks rugby team in New Zealand, but you know, one of their deals is they talk about sweeping the sheds, and they always talk about leaving it better than you found it. That'll be for somebody else to decide, but I feel like when I leave this program, we've left it better than we found it. And it was great before we got here. But I think that every quality in which we're going about our business and the culture in which we've built it and then continue to sustain success, I mean, in 14 years, we've won 6 state championships. We should have won 2 more that we lost by 1 point. And then every year we've been to the semifinals or better. We've won 10 games or more every year. But not just that. It's Mr. Montgomery coming up here to tell you how many discipline problems that we've had in football. Not very many. You know, it's Coach knowing the things that we try to do in our program to try to support all the other sports that are going on. And so to me, that's just as important to me as anything. So I told our kids today, I said, look, you know the choices you got to make. You know how to be good men. You know how to be early. You know responsibility, you know ownership, you've been taught that. And so these kids will keep carrying that on. I mean, that's what Hoover's about. And so Hoover will keep going to a whole nother level without me, all right, because that's what Hoover is. Hoover's about expectations, and Hoover's about a commitment to a tradition of championships and championship lives, and I see that happening.
Was it a tough decision for you?
Yeah. Yeah, very tough. Yeah, and I think it's tough from the standpoint of just because you've been here for so long. You know, there's been a lot of people within my tenure here that have worked their tail off to keep this program and to continue to improve this program the last 14 years. And so when you've been somewhere 14 years, let's just be honest. I mean, when I drive in, I know exactly where I'm going as far as my address at home. I just built a house 4 years ago for my wife. And so, you know, you have those variables. And and now you got to move, you know. And so those are things. And then you think about the normalcy of understanding your day-to-day and how you go about your business, whether it's your class schedule, when your meetings are, you know, when we're lifting in the mornings, to what we have going on in the afternoon, to, you know, my daughter plays softball at Wallace State, so I'm going to be 3 hours away from her now. You know, my son plays at Cumberland University in Tennessee. Now we're another hour away from him. My youngest son is a sophomore, so he'll be a junior next year, plays football and wrestling. So those are the hardest things that you have to think about. But then when you look at your kids every day and know they know, hey, at 6:30 in the morning, we're gonna be lined up for stretch and we're gonna be ready to go. Now, I've gotta start over and I'm gonna have to teach a new group that and teach them a new way and try to build their culture.
So what was it, I guess, that, you know, made it clear for you that this was the right thing for you?
Just that, you know, I've been praying about it. I mean, look, I think when you get to a point, and I don't know if a lot of people do, I never saw myself as being a retiree, you know, but I also see myself as a visionarian. So I'm always about impacting lives, and there was probably still other things that I can do here. But I think you get to a point in time too where, you know, I have a vision of, you know, where I want to continue to see when I'm here, and then the vision of where I'm going. And there's some opportunities to where I'm going that are going to be unbelievable and may even be unprecedented. And so I'm looking forward to that. And I'm looking forward to that. And so, you know, but it was hard. It was hard to make a decision. But I think it was just having a peace of mind to know that this is what I need to do. And if I wasn't at 25 years, I wouldn't even be considering even, you know, thinking about it, you know. And everybody's like, well, why don't you stay 2 or 3 more years? Look, my youngest son, like, he holds his own with anything. So, you know, he's, you know, that was probably the hardest part is he's been here since he's been in kindergarten, you know. And so, but I think this was an opportunity that presented itself that helps me better my family that I don't know if I'll get this opportunity again. So.
Kind of piggyback off her with your youngest son. Did y'all have those conversations too?
Did we? Yeah. Him? Yeah. Yeah, and like I said, most of this transpired this week. And so, you know, so yeah, there's been a lot of talk. And their input was highly important, you know, because I want, number one is I want my wife to be comfortable and I want my wife to feel good. And, you know, anytime you're in a community, it's always tougher on her if you have to move, you know. And so, you know, and then it's tough on the kids if they're still in school. But let me tell you this. Everybody sat down and we talked and we were all in one unison when we got up from the table and there was no doubt about what we needed to do. And so that's why we went forward.
Josh, when you said football's changed a lot in the past 15 years in this state, what do you mean?
It's just changed. I mean, it's different. I mean, you know, I don't know. I mean, when I first got here and I can remember when I was coaching in Oxford and, you know, I was coaching in Aniana, I just think the game was a little bit more pure, you know. And I think that's changed. I think it's changed a little bit. I think schemes have changed. You know, I think things that guys do is a little bit different. I think the athletes have changed. So now it's a different sport. It's faster, it's stronger, it's bigger. And then also from the standpoint of you're seeing kids moving around all over the place. I mean, that's been a big change. I don't think 10 years ago you had this much as that's going on now. And I think it's got a little bit to do with college and transfer portal and all that kind of stuff. And so the game's changed. I mean, it has. It's changed. I think people now understand that facilities are important, you know, and so that's changed a little bit. You know, you just got a lot of different things. Kids now are going to trainers, you know, like, I mean, 10 years ago, kids didn't go to trainers. Now they're going to personal trainers to get this. You got, you know, recruiting court. I mean, like, it's just a lot of stuff that has changed the game a little bit. And there's a lot of different facets, everything from recruiting to, you know, just the game itself. And so, you know, it just has changed. I mean, do you not agree?
No, I do agree, but I just wonder what you were referencing. You know,
yeah. Well, I just think it's changed all the way around. I just think the game has changed in the last 15 years. I mean, there's no doubt. And I think every year you could see something that has changed in it. You know, and it's a lot of variables, but I mean, it is what it is. I mean, and I think you either adjust to it and figure it out, or you're not going to be successful. And so for us here, You know, I'm going to tell you one thing I felt like we did this year is we got our edge back. We got our toughness back a little bit more. We got our discipline back. This was a tight-knit group. And I think that's, if you got to see us play, you saw that. And I think that's what gave us an opportunity in the end to be there, ready to try to play for a championship. Just touching kids' lives. I don't want it to be about wins and losses. I want it to be about, you know, he was out in the community. You know, he goes to the grocery store. You know, he goes out to eat. You know, he goes and watches youth football. You know, he's highly involved with people in the community. I want my legacy to be that I touch lives and not just win ball games, and that I impacted all the players that I coached. Today, my phone is just like on fire. I mean, because I've received more texts from my guys that I've coached from all the way back to 2008 to guys I just coached last year that have talked about, you know, coach, I just appreciate what you've done in my life. I wouldn't be where I'm at without you. And that just means the world to me. And that's what I want my legacy to be.
Coach, I know how competitive you are.
Yeah.
Has it been frustrating that you weren't able to get back since 2017?
Extremely frustrating. Tired of losing in the semifinals. Yeah. Extremely frustrating. But that wasn't the deciding factor of why I'm leaving to go to another state. I can tell you that right now. So, you know, that wasn't the factor in whether I was going to leave or not. So, you know, we were already ready to get back to work. And, you know, and the thing is, that's what I felt like I do a really good job of, us figuring out what we got to do. As soon as the last game was over with, I got a notebook out and then rewriting what we've got to do to try to figure out, you know, what area we got to get better at. And that's what you do, you know. And so, but yeah, it is frustrating. Yeah, I am a competitor, but it's not just frustrating for me. It's frustrating for everybody that's a part of our community, everybody that's part of our school. And I take full responsibility for that because I know the buck stops in my desk, in my office. But nobody hates it worse than the players and the coaches, you know, because they're the ones that's dealing with it every day and every year. And so, you know, but I think we took a step forward this year to where we weren't, like, we didn't kind of get to the last two or three years. You know, we beat Thompson here, you know, and then we won the region. We went undefeated, and we hadn't done that in probably 4 years, 5 years. So I think everything's moving in the right direction.
How does the landscape where we're going kind of differ from the Alabama, like, high school football landscape?
The landscape of where I'm going, it's football's highly, I mean, it's a community-based, smaller community, or, you know, it's its own, you know, and I don't want to, I mean, but they love football. I mean, they love football, just like Hoover loves football. I mean, I'm not going somewhere where they don't like football. I mean, like, so, you know, I want to be somewhere where people, you know, want to be there on Friday nights. You know, I want to be there when people, you know, they hurt as much as I do on Saturday when we don't win, you know, but they're as excited as I am, and probably even more excited than I am on Saturday when we do win. And so this will be a place that, you know, they want to make sure that their football program's where it needs to be, because, I mean, they understand how important it is, not only in their community, but also in their school.